Hi guys.
Hello.
Yes, that's to come back to my YouTube channel. I hope everyone is doing well. I hope we're all happy and yeah. Thank you guys so much for the support so far. I'm so grateful because who would have thought? Anyways, real quick, this week I've been battling with my mind because ever since I started to start this YouTube channel, it hasn't been easy. The devil thought he had. So, every podcast that I listened to all through this week have literally talked about overcoming oppositions and walking in your purpose. And I really thank God for that because I just felt like it was Him trying to tell me that, you know, whatever I'm doing is His will. And it might not... I might not feel like sometimes, but I just have to do it because it's the will of God. So yes, the topic for today is a bit sensitive because I get pretty emotional when I talk about it, or rather I get pretty emotional when I share my experience.
In case you see me cry, I'm sorry. It's not intentional. I try so hard to fight my tears whenever I remember this, but it's not. I can't really.
Now that's shouting. Well, I was shouting. I don't know about others. Yeah. Sorry for the deviation. Anyways.
Turn to somebody on your left hand or your right. Welcome them to the presence of the Lord, and remind them that nobody comes to the presence of the Lord in these things. So please fasten your seatbelts and get ready to hear from the Lord. Pamela, why can't you be serious? I believe that God wants me to share this just because somebody out there needs to hear this, and because it just might help someone with their, you know, with whatever they're going through right now. So let's get straight into this video. Now, from May 2017 to July 2017, I went through the worst phase of my life. I went through very intense depression and it wasn't funny. So I remember then when, because usually when I want something more or when I want something new, I give what I have. So I sow a seed basically. So then I remember I wanted a new phone. So I sowed a seed with my phone and yeah, that was the beginning of my depression. If you know me, you know my phone is my best friend, and it wasn't easy dealing with not having my phone because even prior to getting rid of my phone, I was already going through a lot of things, but my phone was a distraction because I would always watch sermons on YouTube and listen to podcasts and all of that good stuff. But not having my phone just made me realize that I was literally over myself. I was just wallowing in all my, you know, struggles, and I was a mess. I was struggling in every single aspect.
I was struggling emotionally, I was struggling, you know, academically, whatever, spiritually, I was struggling. And I was still withdrawn from everyone because then I remember I literally was always by myself in my room. I wasn't going anywhere. I wasn't attending lectures. Yes, I said it. I wasn't attending lectures. I was always by myself and it was tough. We're not going to go into details. But just
a couple of days before I got rid of my phone, my friend, shout out to you, Maggie, she gave me a Bible. But I wasn't sure why. Like, I didn't have a need for a Bible at that point in time because I had the Bible app on my phone, just like everyone else. So I just took it and I said thank you and I put it in my room. But after I got rid of my phone and I was battling my depression, I remember my routine then was wake up in the morning, turn my TV on, set reminders for like sermons, you know, listen to CD, like watch T.D. Jakes, Joyce Meyer, Joel Osteen, Stephen Frederick, every possible, every, you know, preacher you could possibly think of. I watched all of them on every faith channel that was on my TV. So yeah, that was that was when the Bible came in handy, because I remember that I was writing my plans in the Bible. When I had to read, I read chapters upon chapters, and I had new understandings of different scriptures, and God spoke to me. God gave me revelations, He gave me promises. It was intense for me spiritually and mentally as well, because I became a different person, if I do say so myself. I learned so many things. in that 3 months of my life. Now, one day, I was so fed up that I decided to quit. Yes, I said it, I decided to quit because it was too much for me. So the plan was to go into my kitchen and take a nap and end my life. But God being so good, I didn't. So when I got into my kitchen, I took my life. Now I tried to cut my wrist. Well, I planned to cut my wrist and bleed out because nobody ever came to look for me and I never went to look for anyone. So like, who would come to my room to find me? They'd probably find me like, what, 2 weeks later? But yeah, nobody came to look for me. So I knew that if I had bled out, I would have died eventually. So I went to my kitchen, I took my knife, and I remember trying to cut myself, but it wasn't working. And now this testimony. So that morning, my neighbor came for his knife. I was using my neighbor's knife for like, what, weeks? And he didn't remember to come for it, but that morning he came for his knife. Now I took my neighbor's knife because my knife was very, very blunt. So yeah, my neighbor took his knife, and the knife in my kitchen was mine, and it was so blunt that it can't even cut a paper. So after I tried to cut myself with a knife and it wasn't working, that was when I looked into my hand and I realized that it was the blunt knife that I had. And it dawned on me that it wasn't my time to take my life. And I just knew that that was God trying to tell me that I needed to stay hopeful because there was light at the end of the tunnel. So I remember dropping the knife and crying like there was no tomorrow.
I literally shed so much tears. Nope.
I remember shedding tears so much that, you know, I just cried. I cried a lot. I cried so much, and I promised myself that after that day I was never ever going to attempt anything as stupid as that again in my life. How so I broke out of my depression was, for every time I woke up, I always looked in the mirror and I claimed positive things upon my life. I said to myself that I was fearfully and wonderfully made in Christ Jesus. I was more than a conqueror, or rather, I am more than a conqueror. You know, all of that good stuff. I always praised, I always worshipped, I always, you know, pondered upon God's promises, all the plans and all the words that God gave to me. I always made sure I reminded myself about the fact that God had come through for me before and he will come through again. And I always reminded myself of, you know, the fact that God is faithful and that he had promised. So he would meditate upon my favorite scriptures, like, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. All things are possible to those who believe. The sufferings of this present times are nothing compared to the joy that is coming. So and I cannot say that it was by my strength or by my might. It was literally God. But one thing that I took out of that was that you cannot overcome what you cannot confront. Because if you decide to sit and wallow in your emotions and in your misery, then it will take forever for you to break out of whatever it is that you're going through. So I made a conscious, it wasn't easy, best believe it was not easy, but I made a conscious effort every day to always, always, always stay positive. And God being so good, the earlier I learned what God was trying to teach me in that season, the earlier my breakthrough came. So I learned to be more thankful. I learned to be, you know, to pray more. I learned to praise more. I learned to worship more. I learned a lot during that period of my life. And yeah, after that 3 months, I got the phone that I always wanted. God is so good. God is so good. Like, when I think of God's grace and God's goodness and his mercies upon my life, I can't even begin to talk about it. But anyways, yes, so don't take your life. It's not worth it. Whatever you're going through today, if you hold on to faith, in a couple of months from now or in a couple of weeks from now, you will see that God is faithful and he will come through for you, because he's not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. He has done it for me and he will do it for you. I strongly, strongly do believe that. And I remember always saying to myself that I would tell my story one day, and now look at me telling my story. I thank God for my life, really. I do thank God for my life. So yes, always remember that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all you could ever ask or think. All you have to do is ask, believe, and receive. Now, in another video, we'll talk about, you know, those three things together as one. But yeah, ask, believe, and receive, okay? I pray God gives us the strength to go through whatever it is that we're going through. I pray that he comes through for us in our times of need. I pray that he gives us the grace to be patient and wait upon him, because he will not put us to shame. And Lord Jesus, we thank you for your love and your continuous protection. And we thank you for bringing us, you know, together again, even though we're not literally together, but thank you for our families and for all that you're doing for us. Oh God, we commit our week into your hands. We commit our entire life into your hands. Thank you, God, for the gift of life. Thank you for every single person watching this video right now. Lord, I commit all our intentions into your hands. Oh God, I pray that you give every single person the strength to overcome whatever it is that they're going through, oh God. Help them, Lord Jesus, to make it through every day, oh God. Remember us, oh Lord, even in the time of our needs, because we know that you have provided for us in every season of our lives. God, give us the strength to continue to trust you even when nothing makes sense, oh Lord Jesus. Help us to love one another the way that you have loved us, oh God. May your light continue to shine forth from our life, oh Lord Jesus. Give us the grace, oh Lord Jesus, to continue to do good and to continue to do work of the Lord and to spread the gospel. Meet us at our point of needs and grant us all our heart desires according to your will, oh Lord. We thank you, God, for answered prayers. For in Jesus' name I pray, amen. Yes, so on that note, thank you guys for coming back to listen to me talk again. I know I already said this before. Did I say this already? Was it this video or the other one? Anyway, yes, thank you for watching this video. Please don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to my next video. Well, it's not like I'll literally see you, but you know, I hope you come back to watch my next videos. So yes, until you see my beautiful face again, Jesus loves you. Take care of yourselves. What else? Am I forgetting anything? Yes, subscribe, like, share, comment, all of that good stuff. Yes, so bye.